And then he decided to drive forward about 100 meters, drive into the biggest possible crossfire you can find on this map, and die a horrible death in a couple of seconds. Oh boy. Actually getting penetrated by the STRV there is completely unacceptable, so he has to go. And there we go. Now, something I didn't mention up until now, there is actually a Unicum platoon on the enemy team with the M2 Light and two Panzer IIs, so we have to be careful with those guys. We still should have the upper hand against them, but if they gang up on us and unload their APCRs into our sides and back, we actually could get into a bit of trouble. And what's that? There is also a Panzer IIJ on the enemy team. And this is again hilarious. Look at these guys completely ignoring each other. I mean, we do attempt to take at least the tracks down so he is still for artillery, which is a really smart move, by the way. But for the large part, we will just ignore that guy. We can't really penetrate each other, to be honest, as we could see also in some of the funny moments recently, so let's not waste tens of thousands of credits trying to fruitlessly penetrate each other. Instead, let's go after the softer targets. So far, so bad actually for the team. We are on 3 kills, however, and whoa, 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 we are getting penetrated by the tier 3 tank. Unacceptable. You have to go back to the garage, my friend, really, really quickly. Angle the armor a little bit. Yeah, that certainly helps. Angling about 45 degrees is the ideal way to go with the Panzer IIJ, and that means we take our revenge. We lost a surprisingly big amount of health there though, so we have to be careful. Artillery can now one or two shot us, so yeah, it's not really ideal. In the meantime, we did pull back our scores just a little bit, but that still means that we are 4 tanks behind. We already lost 2/3 of the team. There is only one guy, one other guy who did actually manage to score a kill, and yeah, this is going downhill really fast. Well, lucky for us, we are in the Panzer IIJ. Have a look at that IKV-72. Now that guy could actually be a threat with the howitzer, but nope, he decides to drive sideways on and eat a bunch of shells from us. Now the reload on this thing is lightning fast actually. You have a 10 round clip which you can reload in under 3 seconds, so your actual rate of fire is over 147 rounds a minute, which is mental. But it's required as well, because otherwise your gun is pretty much garbage. Alright, so there is somebody in the cap, probably the M2 Light, which again is a really, really good player, so we have to be careful. We also have to aim a little bit there, because even if we will switch to APCR, those rounds have only 46 millimeters of penetration, and the M2 Light is a surprisingly tough machine, from the front at least, so no wonder it's being used by professional seal covers so often. How was that? Panzer II? Not so tough, at least not against this machine. Now we did scare off the M2 Light, however this is a bit of a cat and mouse game here around the building. That guy is a lot more mobile than us, and there we go, artillery again trying to hit us, luckily avoiding it for the 3rd or 4th time now already. So the M2 Light, if he's careful, we won't be able to catch him. Uh-oh, there is actually somebody behind us. Eat the shell from him. Luckily we managed to put a couple of rounds into the M2 Light. We completely ignore the STRV because he can't penetrate us. I mean, have a look at this. This is just absolutely crazy. He had our size and rear and wasn't able to do a single point of damage to us. Oh, there is the guy who did actually penetrate us from the back. We put a good round into him and again artillery misses us. If those guys would clean up their aim, we would be already dead by now. A single hit would send us back to the garage. And M2 Light in desperation rams himself into the back of us, almost killing himself, and then we finish the job off. Now that, by the way, was a 1v6 situation. There we go, artillery still gunning for us. And now it's a 1v3, all against artillery. Which would be good, But then again, artillery is actually the pretty much the only thing that's really dangerous for us at this stage, and we are a one shot for all of them. So if they lay in ambush and we drive out in the open and they spot us, we are pretty much dead. Should be really a shame. As dirty as it is, after 10 kills you really want to take the game down. We do hesitate a little bit whether to go down to hunt down the artillery. I mean, we are slow as hell, and if they set up an ambush we might be actually driving it to our death. Could stay as well and defend the cap, but then again it's artillery and they just love to camp in the back of the map, so we might actually just waste our time there. And with 9 horsepower per ton at our disposal, we really don't want to waste too much time that's left. Alright, so let's take a quick peek over the corner. Everybody is trying to sneak up there. Nothing so far. It doesn't seem like it. Alright, I guess we just have to grind our teeth and let's get this over with. There is one of them. Oh! He completely misses and the fire helps us to clean him off. Now that was awfully lucky. Let's hug these walls though, because otherwise artillery might hit us. There we go. If we would not have gone into safety, this would have spelled the end of us after 11 kills. Now that shell, by the way, probably means that they are still at the moment around K1, K2, the typical artillery dam. So let's go and see if we can smoke them out. Now there is a little bit of downtime here until we get into position. So until that happens, let's actually talk a little bit about these overpowered low tier machines and if the Panzer IIJ is really the biggest, meanest threat out there in these low tiers. A lot of you will probably say yes. I personally think that Panzer B2 German heavy tank is an even nastier thing on the battlefield. The reason I'm saying that is that thing is always top tier, so matchmaking really works in its favor, which is not the case for the Panzer IIJ. And another reason why we see a lot more Panzer B2s on the battlefield than Panzer IIJs, although the Panzer B2 is probably not as horrendously overpowered, but it's pretty close. The main factor though is that the APCR shells, which you pretty much have to fire a lot on the B2 as well, are a hell of a lot cheaper. As you will see at the end of this battle, running a Panzer IIJ in a longer battle like this will cost you tens of thousands every single game. And I'm not just meaning 10, 20,000, 40, 50, 60,000 easily. Who has the credits to do that game after game? Not many of us, I would say. The Panzer B2 though, on the other hand, even if you run a full APCR loadout, you will lose only a couple thousand credits. And if you mix in a couple of AP runs as well, and there isn't any artillery here, which is not really the news we were looking for. So if you fire a couple of AP runs in a B2, it actually makes some credits as well, which is completely ridiculous for an OP machine like that. So, personal opinion? I hate the B2 a lot more than the Panzer IIJ. Of course, for newer players facing this monstrosity in their brand new machines, I can understand why it has a negative effect on the game. But let's not worry about that. So we didn't find the artillery here, which is not really great news. We have a slow machine and on perilous low health, so we can't really go and chase them. Because for all we know, they could be heading towards our cap. Now that would be actually a disaster. If they would be entering the cap now, they would just outcap us and we wouldn't be able to go back to defend. So let's hope they are not in the vicinity of our cap yet, and they just did hide somewhere. Hopefully we will be able to lure them out and grab a couple more extra kills. Now something to mention here as well, we are sitting here in one of the few of the bushes in the cap, which might not be the best move actually. Because if they decide to blind fire the cap and if they are in position for that, but never mind, there we go, there is one of them. Oh, that was a close miss. Quick reload, there is the other one. Oh, the guy will take a punt as well. Come on. Oh, another close miss. RNG for the win there in the end. So, was it dirty?